Hi there, my name is Trevor Rosdy, teaching that there is another way through life, and it's called Beamism, the art of understanding self. Today I would like to talk about losing your personality. Happy times are when you felt the best, and this is when your personality was shining. Depression comes when your personality takes a dive. Every great moment you had with someone brings out your personality. But what's your personality like with yourself? Personality means the type of person you are by the way you behave, think, and feel. When we're on the outside world, we show a certain personality. If you come from a very difficult background, this will be shown in your personality. If you come from a happy background, this will be shown in your personality. But then you've got the other side. You've got a false personality as well, which means it's a personality that you show the world, but it's not the personality that you really are within your inner world. So how would you like just to have one personality? You have to work it out like this. You know when you're happy, you know when you're in love, you have a great personality. It's a great feeling, isn't it? You love who you are. When you're not in love, your personality takes a dive and you don't love who you are. And this is why you crave somebody to come into your life. Reason being is because it brings out your personality. And this is why when you meet somebody, that you can say to them, "Oh my God, you're such fun, you're brilliant, you make me laugh, you're so generous, you're so kind." All of these great words. It's a personality that we all love. But why can we not sustain it? You can have a personality in your job. You're fun. You're professional. You look after people. You communicate well. But are you communicating well within yourself? So you can go to work and you can be this wonderful person. And then you can go home and you're dreadful. Your lack of communication with your family is also dreadful. So you have a gauge to work with. You know when your personality is good and you know when your personality is bad. Healing comes when you try to understand the two different personalities of who you want to be. So within these two different personalities, you have a high point personality and you have a low point personality. Even when you go and see different friends, one part of your personality will act in a certain way with somebody. One part of your personality will act differently with another part of your friends, will act differently towards somebody else. Every personality brings out someone's personality. And how that worked for me was like this. I realized that I was being all of these different personalities. I haven't quite fathomed out what was the real personality of me. And this is where the beamy comes in, because the beamy is about healing all of these different personalities that you have, that you show to different people. So therefore, people don't really get to know who you are, because you're showing them a side or a personality that is different to what you show somebody else. This is where you can lose energy, because you keep changing who you are. So what is the recipe? In the Be Me philosophy, you have to say to yourself, okay, I know my high personality, I know my low personality, so I need to find something that's in the middle, something that works for me. You know when you're down and you know when you're up, so you need to be able to balance that. And this is how you get in tune with the body, because if you're running a high energy personality, you'll burn out. If you're running at a low energy personality, you will also burn out. You're jumping from one extreme to the other. You can call that bipolar in personality. Maybe this is where they say you have a personality disorder, because you can't quite work out who you are. Beamy, beamyism, is discovering the personality that works for you, and so therefore, once you get this personality that you love being, then you can be that personality to everyone that you meet. Say, for instance, in my human life, I was always talking about fashion, so therefore I looked funky, I looked different, I talked about fashion in such a way there was an excitement there, there was creativity there, there was inspiration there. And of course, everyone's into hair, aren't they? But when that switched, and then all of a sudden I'm talking about spirituality and beamism, love and light, all of these different variations using different words, there was another form of personality that was starting to show itself. So for me, the fashion side of my personality was a job, but the beamy side of me that wanted wisdom, knowledge, and experience, and the gift of healing, wasn't a job. It was an understanding, and it was an experience. And so therefore, your language starts to change. You install yourself with these great words, and you listen to these great words, and you work with these great words, and so therefore, you want to become a being that's understanding, that has compassion, that has love, that has a new awareness with a different level of consciousness, which means you're now starting to understand who you are, you're starting to understand who your friends and family are, and you're starting to see the world in a completely different way. So always try to understand what your personality is, because don't forget, it does mean it's the way that you behave, and it's the way that you think, and the way that you feel. So when you look at that, you have to ask yourself, how am I behaving? And then ask yourself, how am I thinking? What do I think? And then you have to ask yourself, how am I feeling? You must always check in to your feelings to discover truth. And when people talk about discovering truth, that's where truth sits. And everyone is the truth. Everyone has a truth about their journey. Everyone is the truth about what their experience is, but it's really finding the truth and not the illusion or the false personality. If you feel that life is supposed to be about fun, that's a certain amount of personality, but as you know, not all of life can be fun. It goes up and it goes down. So you have to look at, what part of your personality do you like? What part of your personality do you not like? And the bits that you don't like, they're the bits that need healing. And so therefore, you gauge your journey by the way that you think, by the way that you feel, and by the way that you act in life. To find the contentment within yourself is getting the balance between the two. And this is where you hear me say, balance my ego, balance my emotions, become mindfully empty. Them statements are working with your feelings and they're working with your mind. And if you can get the mind and your feelings communicating together, then you produce action. And action becomes different because now your actions are your behavioral points. And so therefore, you love the way that you are behaving. You have to go back and sort of look at things when things didn't work out for you, life didn't work out. You have to be careful what you plan to discover, what works out and what doesn't work out. This is a big problem. It paints pictures. So therefore, if you paint pictures in your mind to perceive a certain idea to come to fruition and it doesn't happen, that means it didn't work out. What I had learned is, don't paint pictures. Only work with what you've got. Only understand where you are now, and you become the painted picture. So the painted picture is within you. So you have to ask yourself, how do I want to think? How do I want to feel? How do I want to act within my life? And that's when you start to understand mastery of body, mind, and energy. A beamy being is a different personality to what the human being is. The beamy being becomes more compassionate, it becomes more loving, it becomes more understanding, and it becomes more aware of the life. And it starts to appreciate life, it starts to appreciate the people in its life, because them people actually are the people that make up your life. So this is the time now where you need to make up your mind. What personality do you want to become, feel, and think? That's your be me right. That's your responsibility to get that part right. So if there's anything worth manifesting, look at different ways within your personality. And this is why I said you always want people to come into your life to show you love or to show you a good time. The reason why is because you're stuck in your inner world, and so therefore you're looking for something from the outer world that brings out your inner world of pain. But I say go into your inner world of your pain, because it's telling you something. And if you can heal that pain, then you will get to the true source of your true personality, which is to be a beamy being, which is find the true self, feel the true self, and then be the true self. And once you get them three things together, couple that up with body, mind, and energy, and then you would discover the greatest gift of being you. My name is Trevor Arbsley. I'll see you on the other side.